everyone, welcome to the corner of my room. I filmed here once before and I kind of like it. If you're wondering, this is like my closet where I keep all of my like baby stuff and stuff like that. Like you can see some stuffed animals. So if you're wondering why I'm wearing the exact same clothes as my last video, it's because it is the same day. If you guys want to see how to do this makeup tutorial, you can watch my last video. So this video today is my school supplies essentials haul. And I literally just sat here for the last hour filming an hour-long video about school supplies essentials and organization tips because I kind of didn't know that I could divide the two, but I don't want my video to be an hour long, so I'm gonna split this video up into two. So this is the school supplies essentials part. These are the supplies that I get every single year, and I know this sounds extremely materialistic, and it is actually really materialistic, but when I get new school supplies that I really like using, it kind of just makes me want to do my homework more, like it motivates me a little bit more. Just like buying workout clothes may motivate some people to work out just because they have like good gear now. It makes me motivated to do homework. I'm not sure if that's for everyone. It's kind of just whatever works, so whatever gets you doing your homework, you know. And I will be a senior this upcoming year, so these are the things that I've just found that work best for me. So I don't know, I thought some of you might be curious. And I also have a really, really good system for keeping organized, so if you guys want to check that out, I'm going to be posting that in the next few days or so. It just took way too long to explain it in one video. So I'm going to go ahead and just get started. I'm just going to show you the things that I got and not try to talk too much about it because I learned that I can talk a lot. Also, if you are going school shopping at this time, I would definitely recommend shopping around because just from my shopping experiences, I've been to like three different stores. The prices vary kind of a lot, like up from $1 to like $3, and that might not seem a lot, but it really does add up. So if that's something you guys are concerned about, you should definitely shop around because some places are a lot cheaper than others. So the first thing that I have here is this hybrid note binder from 5 Star, and this is my absolute favorite binder. I've been using it since the 7th grade, I think. This is $13 and you can find it at Target, or it's $13 at Target, I don't know, you can probably find it in other places. I really, really, really like this binder because it is so small and compact. It's a 1-inch binder, so it kind of forces you to stay really organized and keep everything light. And this is perfect for if you carry around a tote or a purse. So this is pretty small in terms of how binders are. And it's very lightweight, so if that's something that you're looking for, this is the perfect binder for you. So one of the things that I like most about binders being this small is that it does, again, force you to kind of be selective about what you put in your binder, so it makes sure that you don't have too much clutter in here. So it keeps you really organized with just the size itself. Another thing that I really like about it is that it has a super simple design. They have started carrying designed ones, so it's, like, I don't know, I think I saw, like, polka dots. It was very playful, but just kind of a little bit too childish, I don't know. I just really like this simple design. So, the thing that I like about the outside of this is that you can take papers and take notes on top of the binder, because it lays flat. It doesn't slope like this. Another thing about this binder that you can see is that the rings are actually on the outside, which is really, really cool for if you have like a pencil pouch that has a 3-ring attachment on it. So I just usually take my pencil pouch and put it on these 3 rings. It has 5 dividers. 2 of them are like this and the other 3 are kind of just like hardcore paper protectors. It also includes graphing paper and just regular lined paper. So that is this binder. So the next thing that I got that is definitely a back to school essential is this expanding file. This one's the 13 pocket 5-star one, and you guys might figure out by now that I kind of like pink. So I keep these expanding files for past back work. So I put a ton of work, all of the work that I get back, in these files. If you want to do the same thing, and I'll talk about it more in my organization video, but if you guys are looking to do the same thing, you don't really have to worry about the number of pockets it has. The most important thing to look at is the width of the expanding file. So this is not that big, so it might not actually hold all of the homework that I'll have passed back for the entire year, but I'm also planning on possibly graduating early, so it'll probably hold all of my homework for the semester. Also, another essential is a planner and a notebook, but I have not been able to find a notebook with paper that I actually like because there is some paper that I just hate, like when you write on it, it comes off like on the side of your hand. So for the planner that I got last year, I really liked it, but they always change it up a little bit each year, so I didn't really like the version of the planner that I got this year, so I'm gonna look for another one. But those two things are definitely important and essentials for me. And then all of the rest of the things that I'm gonna show you are just my favorite types of like pencils, erasers, and some cheap things that I found. So the first thing that I will show you guys are these pencils. These are the Papermate pencils, and I feel like a lot of people have these. These are probably the best pencils that I have found so far on the market. And I really like how it comes with extra lead, because that is actually really important to have once you run out of lead. And if you have these pencils, they'll last you the entire year. Like, I know that I have had these pencils and I don't have to get pencils at all for the rest of the year unless they break or something. And for erasers, I really like these type of erasers. I don't like the erasers. I don't really like using the erasers that go back here just because they kind of don't erase that much, and you can get a lot harder with your erasing if you have these things. And then I also found these while I was shopping, so I definitely want to try out these. These are retractable, so they kind of, if you push too hard or they get a little bit old, they'll start just retracting on their own. So these look a little bit more promising, so I wanted to try these out. And these are Papermate, so I really like the brand Papermate. And then I also got this USB flash drive at Home Depot or Office Depot. And it was really cool because they had a bunch of these on their like sales section right before you get to the cashier. And this was like the only one that was in the $8 bin for an 8GB thing, but it was actually misplaced. But they gave me the $8 price anyway, so it was like $15, but they gave it to me for $8, so this is adorable. And I got this because I have USB sticks like at home, but sometimes I find that when I bring my computer to school, which is kind of often, a lot of my friends also bring their computers to school, and they have either like pictures that they have of us, or they have music that they want to give me, and I never actually have a USB flash drive, so I'm definitely keeping this in my school bag for those occasions, because it's actually pretty handy to have one around. So the next thing that I got are these post-its, and I really like these ones because you can write on them. I find myself using these a lot. Something that I use them for that seems really obvious that actually not a lot of people do is as a bookmark. So if you're on chapter 15 of your textbook at school, you just mark the page of the chapter 15 and then you can flip right to it every single day. I did that in one of my classes last year, and everyone thought it was like so clever, and I was like, this is probably the most obvious thing, but I will take credit for you. I also find these helpful for if you are doing an English assignment, and for example, you have to find like themes in a book, you can use the different colors for a different theme. So I like these because they come in different colors, but you can also write on them. And these were $6 at Target, but they were like $8 at Home Depot or Office Depot. So again, look around. And then I got these index cards at Office Depot for 25 cents, so that was a really good deal. I really like index cards, and I like the smaller ones because they waste the least amount of paper. So I usually use my index cards as flashcards. So what I'll do is I'll just cut these guys in half because you don't really need the whole thing for just one flashcard. So my favorite pens have to be these G2 old gel roller pens, and I really like how they also come in different colors because I like color coding things. I've tried the fancy like Uniball pens and stuff. They're not actually fancy. I don't know why I said fancy, but I found that these gel pens are a lot better and faster. They're just a lot easier to write faster with. They don't bleed through like the Sharpie fine point pens, and yeah, I just like these. Oh, and then I just picked up this little Vaseline lip therapy at Target. This was $2 at Target, and it is just adorable, so keeping that in my school bag. So yeah, those are basically all of my back to school essentials that I have found work best for me over the years. So be sure to check out my organization tips video that's coming up as my next video, because I feel like I have a really good system that really works for me. So if you guys are looking for tips for organization or just inspiration or something like that, for your own tips, be sure to check that video out because I think I have some good tips. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will talk to you guys later. Bye!